हेलो एंड वेलकम टू अ वेरी स्पेशल एपिसोड ऑफ बट्टा फास्ट. मैं हूं आपका होस्ट अहमद नकवी. मेरे साथ ना ही सिर्फ उस्मान समीउद्दीन बट विद ब्यूटिफुल हेयर एंड डेजलिंग पेंटिंग विनिंग स्माइल रेहानुल हक, चैम्पियन मैनेजर ऑफ द PSL चैम्पियंस इस्लामाबाद यूनाइटेड एज वेल एज ग्लोबल T20 चैम्पियंस टोरंटो नेशनल्स एंड फॉर्मर मैनेजर ऑफ द पाकिस्तान मेंस क्रिकेट टीम. और रेहान का अब अपना एक YouTube चैनल भी है जिसका क्रिकेट मिथ्स के नाम से, राइट?
स्पोर्टिंग मिथ्स. थैंक यू फॉर
स्पोर्टिंग मिथ्स. यार मुझे I knew I'd forgotten. I was going to say I've forgotten it and then I was like, let me try.
Forgotten it would have been worse.
Yeah, I was there. मुझे पता था कि मतलब कुछ ऐसा था जिसमें रेहान का अपना नाम नहीं है. And I was just like, कि ये तो अब याद रखना पड़ेगा. This is a new one.
जो भी ये वाली एपिसोड देखे ना, भर दे हमारे कॉमेंट्स आस्किंग के रेहान की जो पीछे पेंटिंग है वो कहाँ की है और हम कैसे ले सकते हैं, बिकॉज वी बीन डूइंग दिस फॉर इयर्स विद अहमद. मगर अहमद के पीछे बैकग्राउंड कुछ है नहीं. मेरे बारे में, इस वाले बारे में कोई पूछता नहीं है, जो कि बिल्कुल सही है, नहीं पूछना भी नहीं चाहिए. तो रेहान के पीछे जो पेंटिंग है उसके बारे में पूछा. और दूसरी बात, मैंने आज आई वॉन्ट यू टू कॉमेंट ऑन माई, मैंने ब्लू स्वेटर पहना आज, बिकॉज पिछली एपिसोड में आई थिंक हम दोनों ने ब्लैक पहना हुआ था. अहमद, मैंने ब्लैक हुडी पहना था, तुमने भी. और इमरान अहमद खान, जो कि अगर आप ये सुन रहे हैं, तो उनकी एक कॉमेंट आई थी, बड़ी एक ताना आया था. कॉमेंट नहीं थी, उनका एक ताना आया था कि यार शो तो बड़ा अच्छा था मगर कपड़े बड़े बोरिंग थे तुम लोग के. तो अब मैंने थोड़ा सा कलर इन्हांस करा है और अहमद माशाल्लाह, यानी अब क्या कह सकते हैं
इस शर्ट के बारे में. Using my clothes. but the reason कि हमने रेहान को शो पे दावत दी, क्योंकि recently both उस्मान and रेहान did something जो एक एक lost art के ऊपर एक उस्मान wrote an article and रेहान की एक video है जो इस episode के साथ साथ simultaneously release होगी. We'll be putting a link to it in the description. And probably makes sense कि अभी pause करके आप वो video देख लें, because it's shorter and it sets the context. But in both cases, Rehan and specifically, this video is about Saqlain Mushtaq's invention of the Dusra, and then Usman's article talks about what what we lost, I suppose, when we lost the Dusra and how big an impact it had. So right at the start, guys, each one of you, thoda sa batao what you wrote or made, why you did it, what was the thinking behind it?
I think because Usman's wearing a blue sweater today, so Usman should start.
Because I'm older. Aur buzurgon ko pehle se
and I have more hair.
Buzurg ki haisiyat se main shuru karta hoon. No, and actually, you know, I thought the reason I did it also was because once you get this old, guys, I'm not 50 yet, but once you get this old, you start thinking of life in terms of anniversaries. अच्छा यार उसके 10 साल हो गए, अच्छा यार इसके 15 साल हो गए, अच्छा यार उस moment के एक 20 साल हो गए. So I was talking to my lovely great friend, the greatest cricket writer that I know and the greatest writer that I know, Rahul Bhattacharya. वो किसी काम से पूछ रहा था कि यार when was the दूसरा band? ऐसे उसने पूछा मुझसे एक महीने पहले. He just asked me like that कि when was the दूसरा band? He was asking for some work of his or something. And I was like, actually, you know, it wasn't ever banned, but the bowlers who bowled it were banned 10 years ago. And then I remember that, अरे ये तो इसी महीने 10 साल हो जाएंगे since Ajmal was banned. So we're now in October, but Syed Ajmal, you know, one of the greatest characters that I've ever come across on the cricket field, in cricket generally, banned from bowling in September 2014. At the time people were saying कि उसकी दूसरा, he bowls in illegal action, and he was found to have bowled it with an illegal action. He was found to also be bowling at that time his off spin with an illegal action. So, you know, he was banned, but that was also part of, he was the highest profile guy to be banned in that period. But there was a lot of other bowlers who were banned because the ICC was clamping down. ICC ki ek, you know, bahut saalon se ek thi limit ke aap agar 15 degrees se zyada aapki elbow extend hoti hai, effectively flex hoti hai, you know, not that you just throw bent, but you have to go, that movement has to be more than 15 degrees or whatever. And then they decided in the middle of that decade to kind of clamp down on it, which basically what it did was it killed the Dusra. because I think by that stage, nobody really was being able to bowl the dusra without that flex in the action. That one, that doesn't mean that you cannot bowl the dusra without that flex in the action. I think there are real life examples of it happening, and there is also like academic study to show that it might be able to happen. And two, it didn't mean that these guys were cheating. It was just the way their actions were. In a lot of cases, in Ajmal's case, I think it was from overworking and over bowling that his action became kind of raggedy. But you know, that kind of then set me thinking, yaar, pichle 10 saal mein jab se dusra khatam hua, not only have we like lost the dusra, but it's kind of changing the nature of off-spin completely. And then, uske baad, then, you know, we dug into some figures and some facts and basically found that usse pehle jo 10 saal ka period tha, so from 2004 to 2014, आपकी जो टॉप ऑफ टॉप विकेट टेकिंग ऑफ स्पिनर्स की लिस्ट थी उसमें स्पेशलिस्ट ऑफ स्पिनर बॉलर्स थे. ग्रेम स्वान था, मुरली था, सईद अजमल हिमसेल्फ वाज देयर एंड देयर वाज लॉट्स. और उसके बाद से जो लिस्ट है इक्विवेलेंट लिस्ट आफ्टर 2014, बेसिकली आपके पास अश्विन है और लायन द टॉप टू हु आर यू नो ट्रेडिशनल ऑफ स्पिनर्स. और फिर नंबर थ्री पे मोइन अली है और फिर नंबर सेवन पे जो रूट है और फिर नंबर 15 पे जो अभी यानी एक बच्चे ने एक साल भी नहीं हुआ है शोएब बशीर को अपनी करियर शुरू करे हुए बट ही इज ऑलरेडी द 15th हाईएस्ट विकेट टेकिंग ऑफ स्पिनर इन टेस्ट क्रिकेट सिंस 2015 व्हिच यू नो देन इट जस्ट शोज यू लाइक द काइंड ऑफ द हॉलोइंग आउट ऑफ ऑफ स्पिन. सो दैट्स व्हाट द आर्टिकल इज अबाउट दैट यू नो द दूसरा वेंट एंड विद इट प्रोबेबली वेंट द ऑफ स्पिनर. अब अगर अश्विन और लायन जब खत्म करते हैं द बोथ टुवर्ड्स द एंड ऑफ देयर करियर, you got to think who really are the off-spinners, specialist off-spinners that are left, you know, of pedigree. So that's kind of what it was. And, you know, obviously it was talking to Rehan during that time as well and my stats team as well, just to get some numbers on it. But yeah, 10 years since the modern off-spinner died, I think, and definitely 10 years since the Dusra kind of went. That, in a big nutshell, is what the piece was.
So Rehan's video, I think, takes like, you know, the same kind of sentiment, but reduces it to like celebrating the art through to one phrase, which is the thunka. So, yeah. Rehan, agar aap iski tafseel hame samjhayein thodi.
I think bahut mere liye Saqlain Mushtaq is a very special bowler. Uski wajah ye hai ki when I was growing up, to mere ghar mein jitni cricket dekhi jati to mere chacha was a huge cricket fan. तो उन वो जो वो आपको सारों का पता है कि लेग स्पिनर होना चाहिए, लेग स्पिनर विकेट टेकिंग बॉलर है. तो चचा वाज द सेम, ही यूज्ड टू कीप सेइंग के लेग स्पिनर होना चाहिए. तो एज अ चाइल्ड आई यूज्ड टू कॉपी शेन वॉर्न का एक्शन के उस तरह बॉल करे, या कादिर टाइप रन अप जो कि कभी आपसे कंप्लीट नहीं होता बिकॉज वैसी फ्लो कभी आती नहीं आपके रन अप के अंदर. एंड आई कुड नेवर बॉल फास्ट, सो आई थॉट आई बॉल स्पिन. एंड सो द फर्स्ट टाइम आई सॉ Saqlain Mushtaq बॉल, ही वाज लाइक जस्ट क्रेजी. और मुझे याद है हम लोग वो वन टेप वन हैंड जो मैंने वीडियो में मेंशन किया वो खेलते थे, तो उसमें चुटकी स्पिन होती थी. तो आई ट्राइड बोलिंग लाइक दैट विच वर्कड. एंड अगेन द वीडियो इज अबाउट इट वर्किंग इन अ वन टेप वन हैंड गेम जो कि यू नो इतनी छोटी पिच होती है कि आप आराम से ये करके आप बॉल करवा सकते हो, बट टू डू इट ओवर 22 यार्ड्स दैट टेक्स समथिंग स्पेशल. एंड द ठुमका थिंग कम्स फ्रॉम अ स्टोरी विच इज लाइक आई वॉन्ट टू टेल दिस ऑन एयर एज वेल. सो मेरा एक दोस्त, उसकी शादी के ऊपर वी आर ऑल डांस प्रैक्टिसिंग. So there was this step that I couldn't do. Like everyone else could do it. I was struggling with it. And वैसे ही मुझे एक ही step आता है जो मैं हर जगह जाके कर देता हूँ. लेकिन वो
कह रहे लगा था कि कहानी खत्म करो फिर आल.
So उसने मुझे कहा कि वो यार इतना मुश्किल नहीं है. तो I said यार I can't like how do I move my hip and all. तो उसने मुझे कहा कि भाई बहुत simple है. तुमने Saqlain Mushtaq जैसे batters का ठुमका लगवाता था वैसे ठुमका मारना है. So I remember Damian Martin के वो ऐसे होके ऐसे हुआ. So that was actually that step and I did it and it worked for me and humne uske baad wo dance kiya bhi. That's probably only two times in my life where I've been successful at, you know, dancing on stage and credit for that goes to Saqlain Mushtaq. And that's where the thumka idea came in, ke completely batters ko out of shape karna. And the Damian Martin dismissal isliye main mention kar raha hu ke it was 6 years, everyone knew what the dusra was by now. Like even you know, आपको पता है वो क्या बॉल है. और इवन माइकल होल्डिंग व्हेन ही इज ट्राइंग टू डिस्क्राइब इट, ही इज नॉट यूजिंग द वर्ड दूसरा. ही इज सेइंग शेन वॉन कुडंट स्पिन इट एज मच, लाइक अ लेग स्पिनर कुडंट टेक द बॉल अवे फ्रॉम द बैटर एज मच एज अ दूसरा डिड बाय Saqlain एंड प्रोबेबली द बिगेस्ट स्पिनर ऑफ लेग स्पिन ऑफ ऑल टाइम शेन वॉन एज वेल. सो आई थिंक दैट एंटायर डिसमिसल एंड द वे इट हैपेंड, कि उससे पहले गिलक्रिस्ट लाइक कंप्लीटली डिस्ट्रॉयड एवरीवन, वसीम अकरम सेकंड मोस्ट एक्सपेंसिव फिगर्स इन अ वनडे इंटरनेशनल मैच हैपेंड इन दैट गेम. So for Sakland to do that, to first Gilchrist, a left-hander, and then one of the most technically gifted batters of their era, Damien Martin, I think was very special. Or, you know, that match is remembered for Waqar Yunus's wickets. Or Waqar, I think 2-3 matches were there that he had 6 out, 5 out, or 7 out, something like that. But for me, that series was about that Sakland, before that, there was a little time that you felt that he might not be at the same level. But when he bowled those two deliveries, two of the best batters of, you know, that Australian team in one-day international cricket, unko aise defeat karna, I think that was... I'm a stats guy, but to me, that was just art. Like, beautiful to watch and something that can't be explained by just numbers.
So, I wanted Rehan to finish this story because he was telling me very beautifully. It's a very obvious thing that he's talking about. Because, like, Rehan has one step. That step has been done every time in every wedding, whether it's a song or a song. So, this is not Tumka Shumka, never mind, brother. Like, that fake story at least set it up beautifully, because I think when Usman and I were discussing this, like, the first dismissal, jo pehli cheez aapke dimaag mein aati hai, at least mere dimaag mein aati hai, is jis tarike se usne Damien Martin ko out kiya tha, ki wo bilkul hakka bakka reh jata hai. Aur I think ki ek cheez, yeah, hum log ko pata hai achhi tarah, but pace is pace yaar, jo phrase hai, to jab wo zyada mainstream hui, bahut sare log usko literally le rahe hote na, ki it's just about fast bowling. And for us, like, we've always known ke kya kehte hain, it's not about like a pace per se, it's about ke, you know, it's about so much else. And Sakland Mushtaq ka era, and Rehan wali video mein jo bhi clips hain usme nazar aata hai, why Sakland is pace is pace yaar, because he has the same level of bharam and like kind of the celebrations and the send offs. And you know, he's got celebrations. If Gilchrist caught Kalavi, he's like really angry and excited in a way that spinners usually wouldn't be doing. But then your video has another clip where jab wo out karke na, he kind of does like a shimmy, which is just like, you know, which is, it's a very kind of like Asif reaction as well. You know, so wo jo sort of aura hai. And I think like what I felt, Usman, with your piece is ke, Ajmal is like the last kind of Pakistani spinner with an aura, jo aapki kafi lambi chain chalti bhi aa rahi, if you want to take it back to like Qadir, Mushir, Sakland, Ajmal. Beech mein maybe shayad, you know, you didn't have for a few years, but the emergence of Ajmal kind of corrects that. And you don't have like jo dusra ke saath saath, matlab, we can discuss about what was lost in it, but for me, like, it, you know, as Usman's article pointed out, it completely killed off the off spinner as a threat in cricket.
Yeah, I just want to comment, Ahmed, jab tum is video ke editing karoge to please ye jo thumka thoda sa dikhaya tha na, Damien Martin ko jo out karte hue usne Rehan movement kari na aise, that was quite a dance move, to wo please cut karke uska ek gif ya meme usse bana dena. I think that we have to kind of, yeah, exactly. That was fairly, fairly rhythmic, I thought, of Rehan. So, yeh rakhna. But generally, on offspin, yeah, you know, I think Sakland ki jo ek dehshat thi na, jo apne peak zamane mein tha, aur yeh, I know, yeh stats Rehan ke dil pe lagi hui hain, wo jo 95 or 96 mein jo usne ODI wickets to li thi, I think the most 68 and 69 wickets in 2 years consecutive, wo jo uski ek peak thi na, even more, and actually Rehan made a good point, that when he Damien Martin out, that was the 2001 tri-series, I think. Saki, I think, had actually like probably plateaued a little bit. He was coming towards the end. 2 years later, his career, you know, played the last test of his career 3 years after that, I guess. But that mid-90s to late-90s, his peak thi na Sakland ki, that was like unmatched. And it was, main bahar tha, I wasn't like, you know, in Pakistan. Cricket se main pehle bhi keh chuka hu, meri thodi si, I'd fallen a little bit out of love, thodi si indifference thi cricket ki. So I couldn't comprehend ki ek off spinner, you know, Sakland Mushtaq likha wada tha ROB, right arm off break or whatever. I couldn't comprehend ki ek off spinner ye cheeze kar raha hai jo Sakland kar raha tha. Australia mein usne 6 wicket li, India mein usne 4 innings mein 4 fivers liye yaar. Tendulkar ko usne apna bunny bana diya. Like, and he did this against India, in India, the year after Tendulkar and Lakshman and Dravid had taken apart Shane Warne. दे हैड लिटरली टेकन अपार्ट शेन वॉन. शेन वॉन को इन्होंने एकदम नंगा कर दिया था एक तरह से वहां. सकलैन केम द नेक्स्ट ईयर फॉर दैट एशियन टेस्ट चैंपियनशिप एंड टुक अ फाइव फॉर इन फोर इनिंग्स इन अ रो इंक्लूडिंग कंप्लीटली फ्लमक्सिंग तेंदुलकर. चेन्नई वाली भी जो फेमस विकेट है तेंदुलकर की जो स्लॉग है, आई मीन अब मेरी यादाश्त इतनी अच्छी नहीं है, बट आई डिस्टिंक्टली रिमेंबर दैट वाज आल्सो दूसरा बिकॉज ही काइंड ऑफ स्लाइस्ड इट. ही स्लाइसेस इट अप, ही इज ट्राइंग टू हिट इट ओवर मिड विकेट एंड ही स्लाइसेस इट अप एंड इट लूप्स अप टू वसीम एट मिड ऑफ. तो आई एम प्रीटी श्योर दैट वाज दूसरा, बट ही हैड कंप्लीटली लाइक वो जो, और वही मैंने लिखा था आर्टिकल में कि आई थिंक जब गूगली का पहली बार इजाद हुआ था ना क्रिकेट में, उस वक्त कुछ नहीं था, मीडिया नहीं था, सोशल मीडिया नहीं था, दो मुल्क खेलते थे क्रिकेट बेसिकली. मगर उसकी जो दहशत के बारे में जो लिखा जाता है ना, गूगली क्या डिलीवरी थी, सबको पागल कर दिया पूरी दुनिया का, वी वर नॉट अराउंड टू सी दैट डिलीवरी एंड व्हाट हैवक द गूगली रीक्ड एट द टाइम, बट वी वर अराउंड टू सी द हैवक दैट द दूसरा रीक्ड इनिशियली. शुरू में जो सकलैन मुश्ताक की जो दूसरा उसने निकाली थी ना, एंड सम ऑफ दोस डिलीवरीज इन दोस अर्ली इयर्स लाइक इनसेन यार, व्हाट दे वर डूइंग वो अनथिंकेबल था कि यार एक ऑफ स्पिनर शॉर्ट स्लीव्स में आके बोलिंग करा रहा है विद अ क्लीन आर्म एक्शन, ड्रिफ्टिंग इट इन एंड देन नॉट जस्ट ड्रिफ्टिंग इट अवे बट ब्रेकिंग इट अवे बिग डिस्टेंसेस. दैट वाज लाइक इट वाज माइंड ब्लोइंग. इट वाज एब्सोल्युटली माइंड ब्लोइंग. सो दैट यू नो रेहान, आई थिंक यू टॉक अबाउट दिस इन टर्म्स ऑफ इनोवेशन, दैट वाज द फर्स्ट रियल इनोवेशन सीन इन स्पिन बोलिंग फॉर लाइक अ लॉन्ग लॉन्ग टाइम. इट वाज अ जेन्युइन इनोवेशन.
सुआरेस फॉर एग्जांपल, आई थिंक सुआरेस इज अ परफेक्ट लिंक टू सकलैन मुश्ताक हियर, कि सुआरेस अक्सर जब आप उससे बात करते हैं how he plays his football, he remembers street football. He remembers ke wo nutmeg maar raha hai, which is basically an attempt to dodge the other person, chalaki karna, shoulder drop karna. Wo jab bhi is baare mein baat karta hai to wo kehta hai ki maine apni gali se seekha hai. And I feel wo jo chalaki wali cheez hai Sakhlan Mushtaq ki bowling ke andar, that also is like part of Pakistani culture as well, ki koi jugaad nikal lo, koi tareeka nikal lo, which is like not conventional, but will get you the results. And I think wo jo chalaki aur non-conventionalism hai, that is a part of Pakistan cricket, which unfortunately hum abhi bhi baat karte hain, you know, technique ye nahi chahiye, wo nahi chahiye, but every great innovation that's come from Pakistan cricket has come from chalaki ya koi jugaad nikalna ya koi aisa tarika. So I feel Sakhlan is the, you know, the height of that, ke usne wo jo dusra invent kiya and uske baad, you know, the entire world was just did not know, as Usman mentioned in his piece as well, ke unko pata hi nahi isko bolna kya hai, other one, spinning the other way, drifter, top spinner, like they couldn't describe it, like even, you know, physics terms ke andar usko describe nahi kar sakte, because we, as Usman earlier mentioned, ki aap leg spin karate ho, so leg spin ki one of the most important things about any leg spinner is the amount of drift he gets. But for Sakhlan to be doing it with an off spin thing, I think utni drift, agar unfortunately us waqt tak aapke paas Hawkeye data wagera nahi tha, but I'm sure ki agar ab usko aap AI ke through analyze karein, to the amount of drift that he got on his dusra made it even more special. And I feel ke main cricket mein jab se at least maine apne lifetime mein itni unbelievable invention nahi dekhi jitni dusra thi, and it completely changed the role of an off spinner in especially white ball cricket. Yani abhi bhi Ashwin aur Nathan Lyon ki baat ki, to that's test cricket, right? But what's happening in white ball cricket with off spinners is like, I can't see anyone right now being a regular in their teams.
Yeah, I think कि एक चीज़ जो मेरी नज़र में थी, you know, उस्मान ने जो आर्टिकल लिखा, एंड लाइक दैट बैन, I was writing quite regularly when Ajmal was banned. और मेरे लिए also आपको इससे बहुत ज़्यादा वाजे हो रहा था कि क्रिकेट की अपनी मतलब तारीख और कल्चर क्या है, right? क्योंकि एक बात यह कि आप इतने साल, मतलब 200 साल से क्रिकेट चल रही थी, मगर उसके अंदर ये वेरिएशन लाना ऑफ स्पिन के ज़रिए, कि फिंगर स्पिनर जो है बेसिकली रिहान की वीडियो में जिसको चुटकी बॉल आप वन टिप वन आउट पे करते हैं, वो नो वन हैड बीन एबल टू मास्टर इट एंड बी एबल टू पुल इट ऑफ एट इंटरनेशनल लेवल. आई एम श्योर किसी, यू नो, हुई होगी, बट टू बी एबल टू बोल इट दैट वेल विद दैट मच कंट्रोल. एंड सकलैन ऑब्वियसली वाज द मास्टर ऑल्सो इन द सेंस कि यू नो यू कुड सी दैट बोथ विद अजमल एंड विद मुरली द अदर काइंड ऑफ रियली गुड एक्सपोनेंट्स ऑफ द दूसरा, देयर वाज अ लॉट ऑफ the क्या कहते हैं उनके action was less conventional. Sakhlan almost like जो मैं videos देख रहा था, and they're not great quality, but almost seems like it's coming, you know, it is, he's getting mostly from the front of his hand, not so much from like the kind of snap that Ajmal ki dusra mein zyada aapko dikhai deta hai. बहरहाल पॉइंट ये था कि उसकी रिएक्शन भी जो रेहान जो बात कर रहा है कि किसी को उसको नाम नहीं समझ आ रहा था क्या दें, और गूगली का भी बड़ा एक ऐसा नाम है जो द वर्ड हैज़ नथिंग टू डू विद क्रिकेट, बिकॉज आई फील लाइक यू नो क्रिकेट हैज़ ऑलवेज लुक्ड अपॉन एनी काइंड ऑफ इनोवेशन फ्रॉम द बॉलर्स विद मिसट्रस्ट, एंड पर्टिकुलरली जो दूसरा के अराउंड डिस्कोर्स भी था वो भी इतना क्रेजी था कि मतलब यू नो यह है कि ओ आप अगर दूसरा अलाउ कर रहे हैं तो आप जो है वो क्रिकेट को बेसबॉल बना रहे हैं और सब खड़े खड़े बट्टा फास्ट करा रहे होंगे, व्हेन आई मीन दे इज प्रीटी सिंपल यू नो यू कुड मे बी यू कुड लेजिस्लेट अराउंड दैट क्वाइट इजीली, यू कुड बी लाइक ओके इस एक्शन के अंदर आप इससे ज्यादा तेज ना कराएं व्हाटएवर द हेल, बट पॉइंट वाज कि नो वन वाज रियली इंटरेस्टेड इन लुकिंग फॉर अ सॉल्यूशन व्हिच इंक्लूड्स द दूसरा इनटू the kind of legal framework, so to speak. खास तौर पे जब एक दफा मुरली के टेस्ट के बाद ये अंदाजा हो गया था कि ये कोई यू नो ह्यूमन नेचुरल चीज नहीं है कि 15 डिग्रीज के अंदर सबका आर्म रहता है. वंस यू न्यू दैट दैट्स द ह्यूमन बॉडी हैज डिफरेंट पॉसिबिलिटीज, एंड यू नो आई अंडरस्टैंड मे बी नॉट वांटिंग पीपल टू बोलिंग फास्ट विद लाइक अ फ्लेक्स इन देयर एक्शन और समथिंग दैट्स नॉट स्ट्रेट आर्म और समथिंग, बट with spin I never understood it, or khas taur pe now you see that ke with you know like when you look at something like tape ball cricket in Pakistan, I feel that's a cricket that's kind of looked at ke acha jo abhi rules hain uske mutabik bilkul aap you know reduce cricket down to its barest essentials, to batting mein aapko har ball pe chakka marna hai aur bowling mein ya to aap bounce karaoge ya aap york karoge, aur uski wajah yahi hai ke matlab you know once you take out a lot of the other assistance that bowlers can have, फिर उनके पास ज़्यादा options नहीं बचती हैं खास तौर पर जितना आप attacking तरीके से cricket खेलते जा रहे हैं, and that to me like just the kind of cricket never wanted to embrace it. Googly itself also had a bad rap for a long time, but the दूसरा you know as Usman's article pointed out was just basically legislated out of use.
You know, I think उसका एक जो था ना, because वही 10 साल पहले जब ये अजमल का हुआ था, तो I had done like a long piece on actions और you know किस तरह से काफी detailed piece था. I spoke to a lot of guys who were doing like research in universities, working with the ICC and working with biomechanics labs. So one good thing and one bad thing happened. एक चीज थी, the good thing was कि ICC ने जिस तरीके से process initiate करी, they took like the sting of emotion out of the whole chucking debate. Wo chucking word generally khatam ho gaya, and you know the language was less accusatory. It wasn't ke yaar ye banda cheating kar raha hai, it was just ke inke action ke sath ek problem hai. Until wo fix nahi kar sakte hain wo action, ye bowling nahi kar sakte hain, to lihaza aap fix kar le, then you can come back to bowl. You know they took that morality thing jo murli ke time mein shuru mein thi, jo harbhajan ke time mein thi, jo shoaib ke time mein thi, they got that out, which was actually very necessary, it was needed. But the bad thing, or the one regret at least I have, is jo maine us waqt research kari thi aur jo academics se meri baat hui thi, you know they were on the verge of finding out a lot of really interesting stuff through biomechanics about how elbow movements and flex and stuff actually affect, or whether or not they affect pace, whether or not they affect turn. Questions like, you know, there was one research that was supposed to be happening at the time and I never followed up. But there was one research happening ke bhai, is it possible to bowl the dusra without a flex interaction? And now they didn't have footage of Saklan, but they had found a kid in Australia, a young kid who was able to bowl it without any kind of outward, you know, looking ajeeb weirdness in his action. But I think that was because he had, like, it was crazy research. He had had an accident or uska shoulder thoda sa effect hua tha, and because of that he was somehow able to access these joints in a way that allowed him to bowl the dusra without flexing, you know. So my only I guess regret and question would be ki I wish that the ICC had jumped into that field of science even more, and I know it would have created a mess for them, but I wish they had done it just so we could get more about whether a kink in that action, whether hyperextension or whatever, actually gives you an advantage in whether it's pace, whether it's spin, whatever.
By Usman, my question with the Ajmal thing is, it feels very similar to how La Liga clamped down on taxation. तो उन्होंने सबसे पहले मेसी और क्रिस्टियानो रोनाल्डो को पकड़ा था और एंड में वो कुछ निकला नहीं था, बट बेसिकली वो छोटे छोटे फ्रॉड से वो आज भी केसेस चल रहे हैं, बट दैट वॉज बेसिकली के गेट द टू बिगेस्ट नेम्स एंड मेक एन एग्जाम्पल आउट ऑफ देम. And I feel Ajmal was very similar to that as well, ke they wanted to make an example out of someone and who was a bigger name at the time than Ajmal.
There was a lot of thinking like that at the time. Lekin tum agar check karo na timeline, to Ajmal se pehle koi 6-7 bowlers call hue the in that period, and Ajmal ke baad bhi 4-5 aur the. So in that whole like 18 month period, there were like 15-16 bowlers who were called. And it just so happened that Ajmal was the highest profile bowler of a dusra at the time.
I feel
the context needed here is ke Usman jo baat kar raha hai jab Muralidharan ke khilaf baat chali hui thi. I mean, I would encourage people to look up whatever accounts they can find from that era, because they are reprehensibly racist. I'm not even going to beat around the bush ke they're problematic. They're messed up. How Daryl Hare behaved with Muralidharan is messed up. And the way the humiliations he was put through, it was crazy. Uske banisbat jo Ajmal ke saath hua, wo itna bura nahi tha. But I would still feel that it, you know, like jaise Usman, you're talking about ki unhone kaha ki achha theek hai, it's not ki wo cheat kar raha hai, but aapke action mein ye galat hai, isko sahi hona hai. Which, as you pointed out, that actually there is no firm academic basis ki ye galat ya sahi hai ya nahi hai. We still need to do a lot more research there. But they still drew a line in the sand, right? And I think that was back then. I remember they went a few years where they kind of really relaxed. And then all of a sudden, Ashwin is subtweeting, achha, main bhi phir lambi sleeves pehen leta hun, aur main bhi phir vatta karane lagunga, ya, you know, somebody else is making comments. The English and the...
In the ICC's defense, Ajmal was also called, if you remember, in 2009. So, you know, there was a kind of long arc.
It was the first time Ajmal comes into the scene, and uske baad the ICC also relaxed for a few years, which is why when the clampdown resumed, us waqt yahi tha ki acha ab, and it wasn't just Ajmal, kafi saare logon ko ye kaha ja raha tha. Narayan is another example of somebody who had to, you know, deal with a lot of that insinuation. Or yes, ke wo Murli level nahi tha, but ek to ke bahut hakarat ki nazaron se dekha jata tha un bowlers ko after that crackdown began. And secondly, khas karke Pakistan mein, jahan pe matlab, you know, agar 90s mein jitni bhi innovation ho rahi thi, to uske baad se jo usi generation ke log jab bade hue hain aur khud coaches bane, the kind of reactionism that they have shown, like dusra ke khilaf domestic cricket mein ji itna tha sab ke action tabah kar diye hain, sab ladke ab aise hi karate hain, zaya kar diya unko, ye kar diya, wo kar diya, which I think, you know, they threw the baby out with the bathwater, because like as Usman's pointing out, like there are ways of getting there, and maybe, you know, the first generation doesn't, but after a while somebody comes up ke haan aap apna bazu aise rakhe hain waise rakhe hain ya ye wali exercise kare ye wo, and you'll start developing. Like, it's a skill that can be developed, but it became so demonized. And I think uska evidence yahi hai ki uske baad se off spinner hi specialist aana band ho gaye. Matlab, since that ban, Leon and Lyon and Ashwin were playing before it, there hasn't been a decent international off spinner in a decade.
One of the like great time traveling things to do would be ke Saqlain ke jo earliest dusra hai na, wo aap kisi tarah se retrospectively aap check kare through the angle and lens of biomechanics, because it was amazing yaar. Like, you know, kuch video aapko mil jayenge Saqlain ke which are still fairly decent quality, and you see him bowling his dusra, and I swear yaar usme koi aapko flex nahi nazar aata hai, koi jerkiness nahi nazar aati. It's just his same action kind of, and obviously the footage is not the same quality and stuff, but I would love yaar ki agar aapke paas time travel ki ek ability hoti na, to use aap utha ke ek biomechanics lab mein abhi bhi shayad karwa sake aap, you know, get him to bowl a dusra with the stuff on him and see how he does it, because I think generally think
he did.
Ha, go on.
In 2014, when Ajmal got banned, so Ajmal was working with Saqlain Mushtaq at the time, and Saqlain Mushtaq did do it, and he was doing it without the 15-degree bend. And Ajmal also started bowling a dusra without a 15-degree bend. The only difference was that Ajmal had to become more sidearm now. So he had to change his action. So, like, it's not like it is not possible. Agar Saqlain international level pe ye kar raha tha, aur dusri cheez, agar aap consistently 6-7 saal chucking kar rahe hain, to aapka shoulder, elbow, vagera sab ud jayega. या आप किसी भी यानी बायो मैकेनिक्स के बंदे से भी पूछ लें कि आप इतने कंसिस्टेंटली अगर सेम चीज कर रहे हैं और चक कर रहे हैं तो आपका शोल्डर वगैरह सब कुछ फारिग हो जाएगा. सो ही डिड इट फॉर दैट लॉन्ग. एंड इवन अगर 2014 में लाइक व्हेन हिज जॉइंट्स आर नॉट एट हिज 100% एंड ही इज पास्ट यू नो इज रिटायर्ड एंड रिटायर्ड फॉर इयर्स नाउ, इफ ही स्टिल बॉलिंग 22 यार्ड्स के ऊपर दूसरा विदाउट अ 15 डिग्री बेंड, देन यू नो एट हिज प्राइम आई वुड एट लीस्ट एक्सपेक्ट के ही वाज बॉलिंग इट विदाउट यू नो लेस देन 15 डिग्री बेंड इन द आर्म.
एक पैरेलल एग्जांपल है ऑफ हाउ व्हाट वी सी इज नॉट व्हाट एक्चुअली इज हैपनिंग, राइट? आई डोंट नो इफ यू गाइस रिमेंबर, बट मुरली ने दो टेलीवाइज टेस्ट करे थे. इफ यू गाइस रिमेंबर, वो कास्ट एक स्टील कास्ट ऑलमोस्ट उनके, यू नो, एंड ही वाज एंड ओके मुरली वाज यूनिक इन दैट ही वाजंट रियली अ फिंगर स्पिनर, ही वाज एनीवे रिस्ट स्पिनर. उसकी तो रिस्ट ही एक ऐसी थी, सो ही यूज्ड टू बॉल दूसरा विद द रिस्ट मोर देन एनीथिंग. लेकिन ही ऑल्सो शोड दैट दोज वेरी बेसिक रूडिमेंट्री टेस्ट showed you that he wasn't doing what you thought he was doing to get that turn. So, you know, something like that with Saqlain, maybe not with Ajmal, but with other bowlers, I'm just saying that, you know, the possibility that the Dusra could be bowled without transgressing the laws as the ICC sees it, I think is possible.
See, I think really fascinating is that you had a वक्त था जब मतलब क्रिकेट के अंदर इनहेरेंटली डला हुआ था कि यार कुछ नया नहीं लाओ. मतलब 100 साल तो होने लगे थे कि लेग साइड को एक्सेप्ट करने में. तो द स्पोर्ट रियली हेट्स डूइंग थिंग्स इनोवेटिवली, विच मेंट दैट इट एक्चुअली डिडंट हैव अ लॉट ऑफ रेगुलेशन अराउंड इट एज वेल, विच मेंट के जो मतलब यू नो स्पेशली इन द सेकेंड हाफ द 20th सेंचुरी, वेदर इट्स लाइक द वेस्ट इंडियंस और you know, Pakistanis in particular with reverse and dusra, they are kind of using that huge leeway in the regulations to kind of see, okay, where can we innovate over here, right? And then once the cricket kind of formalizes and comes up with a lot of this legislation and it kind of reinforces ke bhai yahan bowling mein na kuch naya nahi aana, hum ye galat hai, ye chucking hai ya ye hai ya wo hai, like matlab wahi agar baat ho rahi hai ke अजमल कैसे करा रहा है या सकलैन कैसे करा रहा है, लाइक आई डोंट रियली केयर अगर 15 डिग्री से बाहर कोई जा रहा है. मतलब यू नो व्हाट इज लाइक इफ द इशू इज के जी वो खतरनाक है या क्या है, लाइक आई थिंक एट दिस पॉइंट तो बैटिंग एंड प्रोटेक्टिव इक्विपमेंट इज नॉट एक्सपोजिंग यू टू एनी मेजर डेंजर्स एनीवे, पर्टिकुलरली अगर कोई स्पिनर कर रहा है. और दूसरी चीज वही है कि देन यू कंप्लीटली क्लैम्प डाउन ऑन एनी काइंड ऑफ इनोवेशन, राइट? लाइक If you're somebody like Murli who's got these flexible joints, or somebody like Shoaib Akhtar, if you're somebody like Saqlain who's got that kind of vision, ke yo, why don't I try something else? Cricket, unfortunately, you know, it's for bowlers. For batters, it's really, really encouraging to come up with whatever the hell they want to come up with. But for bowlers, it's really this all of this legislation, whether you see it with reverse, where you know, various times they've completely legislated it out of the game and then it comes back every now and then. But, you know, whether it's the number of balls they're using or the kind of crackdown they're doing, etc., etc. Or dusra bhi puri tarike se aapne legislate karke bahar nikal diya, rather than, and I don't, to be fair to ICC or whatever, I'm not saying ki koi bada aasan tarika tha is cheez ko flourish karne ka, but you had this beautiful kind of reality, nostalgia alert, in the past where you could create these really, really amazing innovations, which now because of the way the game has gone, like at least for bowling, it bahut bahut mushkil hai kisi bowler ke dimag mein bhi ye cheeze aaye ki acha main kuch mukhtalif try karu.
Acha, just one thing on this one, the you know dangerous thing. So, you know, a lot of people will say ki oh ye koi gali cricket to nahi ho rahi ki tum baat karo ki spinner ko allow kar do aur fast bowler ko na allow karo beta. So, you know, that happens a lot in our gali cricket. तो आईसीसी जब आईसीसी का एक और रेगुलेशन है कि अगर आपका टेस्ट मैच में बैड लाइट हो रही हो तो अंपायर्स कहते हैं अगर आपने प्ले ऑन करना है तो स्पिनर लगा दो, फास्ट बॉलर ना लगा दो. सो आई फील कि अगर वो आप कर सकते हो तो दिस इज ऑल्सो समथिंग दैट यू कैन ऐड, लाइक शो अ लिटिल फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी. हर चीज को सेम लेंस से देखोगे तो देर विल बी नो इनोवेशन एट ऑल, स्पेशली इन बॉलिंग. यानी अभी फॉर एग्जाम्पल कोविड के टाइम पे आपने बैन किया कि आप बॉल को थूक नहीं लगा सकते, तो अभी तक बैन है वो. तो आई मीन व्हाट्स हैपनिंग विद दैट. फिर आपने कहा कि जी वनडे क्रिकेट के अंदर हम लोग एक एक्स्ट्रा फील्डर इनसाइड द रिंग लेके आएंगे बिटवीन द 11th एंड द 40th ओवर, तो उस पे आप यू लुक एट स्पिनर्स नंबर्स नाउ, कंपेयर देम टू 10 इयर्स अगो और बिफोर दैट, तो नो स्पिनर इज एवरेजिंग अंडर 30. अगर आप अच्छी पिच पे बॉलिंग कर रहे हो तो आपकी एवरेज कोई 30-35 के करीब जाकर हो रही है और आपकी इकोनॉमी 5.5-6 के ऊपर चली गई है. और यू नो वन डे इंटरनेशनल नाउ फील्स लाइक एन एक्सटेंडेड T20 गेम एंड पीपल वर सेइंग के ओ वन डे क्रिकेट बेहतर होगी इससे एंड पीपल विल स्टार्ट वॉचिंग इट मोर. वॉट हैज एक्चुअली हैपेंड इज पीपल आर वॉचिंग इट लेस एंड नाउ इट इज ऑन द वर्ज ऑफ एक्चुअली डाइंग. लाइक इट वॉजन डाइंग 5 years अगो बट इट इज डाइंग नाउ. वी ऑल नो के वन डे क्रिकेट इवेंचुअली विल यू नो इट that's the one format which will eventually you know only maybe happen after 4 years and that's the long term plan I feel as well. But if you do not allow these innovations to happen and thoda sa aap flexibility nahi doge to it will become very you know monotonous in terms of how everyone is playing. Like I remember still one of my favorite innings that I remember is agar aap dono ko yaad ho to Doug Merrillier was a Zimbabwe ka batter and he went to India and he played the dil scoop jiska baad mein naam ki you know that ram shot. He was the first one to play that, right? And everyone was like in awe of that shot. Ke yaar ye kya shot mari hai? Because he was a batter. Agar yahi cheez koi baller karta ke wo you know apna run up mein bhagte hue thoda sa left chala jata ya thoda sa right chala jata to usko terms like cheating use hoti. Like Murli took 800 wickets and they still call him a cheater. Like usne koi usne to nahi kaha tha mujhe khelne do yaar. Usne televised test.
सॉरी आई सॉरी आई एम इंटरप्टिंग यू, मगर तुम तो बात कर रहे हो कि दिल स्कूप की उसकी जो भी रिएक्शन थी वो तो एक एक मतलब सोशल रिएक्शन थी. जब केविन पीटरसन ने रिवर्स हिट स्विच हिट की थी वेयर ही लिटरली स्विचेस फ्रॉम लेफ्ट टू राइट द नेक्स्ट डे द एमसीसी पुट आउट अ बायलॉ सेइंग दैट दिस इज लीगल. अगर और जबकि बॉलर जो है अगर रन अप में वो अपना हाथ बदले उसको पहले से बताना है कि जी मैं अब लेफ्ट आर्म मारूं राइट आर्म मारूं. इज एनी you know batter supposed to do that ke ball se pehle ji agla shot mein switch hit khelne laga. So that to me exactly. is like the easiest way of saying ke yaar aapki matlab wo soch hi alag hai. Wo agle din khushi khushi mcc ne press release kar li, wah yaar naya shot ijaad ho gaya, great, I love innovation. But then why aren't bowlers allowed to do that? And I think part of the answer I'll give is ke if you look at any sport jiske andar offense or defense is very obviously different, whether like football and cricket and wagaira. So for the last like 30-40 years neoliberal era mein, they've all really made this effort to make it a lot easier for offense and make it much much harder for games to be defensive. Or matlab I think ek hamesha sa assumption rahi hai ki log zyada dekhte hain jab zyada offense hoti hai, zyada goals ho, zyada runs ho, etc etc. And I don't know, like I've never been totally convinced of that. And I think we see that with ODIs where every time you have a World Cup where the pressure of the World Cup and maybe a little bit of the you know, 2019 with the conditions also means that you those crazy numbers of one day scores come down and it becomes a more balanced and thus more exciting format.
I mean, it's simple math. Yeah, the lower scoring the game is, the more competitive it's going to be. It's simple math. Mm-hmm. Like अगर आप 400 कर रहे हो तो दूसरी टीम 320 कर रही है, दैट्स एन 80 रन डिफरेंस. तो लाइक यू डोंट सी क्लोज मैचेस एज मच एज यू यूज्ड टू इन ओडीआई क्रिकेट बिकॉज बॉलर्स के पास कुछ बचा ही नहीं. एंड स्पेशली लाइक द नंबर्स दैट बैटर्स नाउ हैव बिकॉज ऑफ दैट अदर फील्डर रूल एज वेल. तो स्पिनर्स तो ऑफ स्पिनर तो भूल जाएं आप, बाकी स्पिनर्स भी बिल्कुल ही खत्म होने लग गए. एंड ऑन दी वन थिंग, सॉरी आई एम डाइग्रेसिंग ऑन द सक्लैन एक्शन थिंग. I remember someone put out I forgot who put out a video of Rashid Khan ke jab wo googly karta hai to uski ek certain type of grip hoti hai. To then next ball usne leg spin ki grip se googly kar di. To Saclan's difference of dusra aap kisi bhi aur bowler ko duniya mein utha kar dekh le to unka koi difference hai, like you can spot it. But you ask any batter from that generation if they could pick Saclan's dusra from the hand, I don't think you'll find more than one or two people. I still remember like Lara's answer to this was just sweeping. That was his answer. Ke agar main kabhi khelunga to I'll just sweep him. So, you know, I don't remember anyone saying that they ever picked him.
So I think this is actually, I mean, you can go back and look at those videos. Ke, at least ye mera takeaway tha ke in the earlier iterations of the Dusra, it feels, you can tell that it's like he's pushing it from the front of the hand. By the time that he's kind of a master of it, like at least TV se to bahut mushkil hai batana ke uske arch mein ye ja raha hai. But then the death of Saclan Mushtaq's career and the dusra, which very brutally recounted in pundits from Pakistan, ki ji usne phir kaha tha ki main 2004 की सीरीज में तीसरा भी लाया हूँ, एंड देन इंडियन जर्नलिस्ट वर लाइक वो दूसरा ये तीसरा ये चौका, बिकॉज सकलैन वॉज डिस्ट्रॉयड बाय सहवाग इन दैट सीरीज. बट उस वक्त तक ही हैड ऑल्सो दैट नाउ यू नो लाइक ना ही वो उसकी टर्न इतनी ज़्यादा थी और ना ही उसकी क्या कहते हैं एक्शन में इतना सटलिटी रह गई थी. What I find most interesting is that this all of this represents like a technical master, right? Like ek toh there's a virtuoso who's like just super talented and doing amazing thing. Like you can tell that Saklan is like a very precise engineer of off-spin bowling, a very specific craft, underlooked craft of cricket. And then this guy becomes a coach and he's like kudrat ka nizam, like but I mean, it's impossible to talk cricket with this dude. Like, you know, he just exists in like, he's like an AI generator of cricket cliche. Like, not just with Kudrat Ka Nizam, like, aur dafa bhi agar aap baat karte hain, he explains it in the most generic terms. And it's so frustrating because there's just like this guy, and it's fine, not every artist can explain their process, but such a technical process you're not able to explain or want to explain.
I think that's the thing, like, you know, even like, even if you speak to like Waseem or somebody, like ye meri ek hamesha ek hai Waseem bhai ke sath, you know, he almost talks about his bowling in like passing broad brush strokes, jahan fir maine thodi idhar se angle nikal ke ye kar diya wo kar diya, whereas other guys, you speak to other guys about bowling and they'll really tell you about the craft of what they do and the skill and the technique of what they do, right down to like the last, you know, little twist of the finger, top finger. Anderson se baat karo to wo sahi se tumhe samjha ke ekdam batayega. Waseem bhai was just like, fir maine bahar se aise nikal di, which as much as it's a complaint, I also quite like it because it keeps that kind of mystique about these guys. Yeah, you know, if Saklan was to come and like really break down his dusra, a little part of me might die, a little part of my 90s Asad might just die in that. Yaar, nahi, mujhe nahi samajhna hai, mujhe bas wohi thodi si uski mystery rakhni hai. I want it to stay that way because that places Saklan's dusra away from and separate to the dusras that followed after. Yeah, because baad mein to sabhi kara rahe the, Shoaib Malik dusra kara raha tha, Mohammad Hafeez dusra kara raha tha.
Yeah.
Anybody work there? So
Mohammad Hafeez, man.
Why don't you just ask Mohammad Hafeez?
That actually isn't, you know, that's not a bad thing. Like, I feel at least cricket mein, jab aap kabhi baat karte hain, Hafeez is still pretty articulate compared to a lot of these guys. And I feel while Usman is right, ki haan, usko demystify na karo ya jo kuch bhi karo, but like jaise ke Waseem bhai ke saath at least I've had the good fortune ke, you know, he'll be galti se bata dete ki kehte hain yaar wo ball ek dafa matlab nets mein, I remember he just picked it up, he's like yaar dekho aise karo na, and it just like freaking swung. But then he explained ke us din mera kandha thaka hua tha, maine yun karai, and by mistake he slips out something that kind of demystifies it. So literally with Saklan, at least, and maybe it's just my experience, you guys have also spoken to him, worked with him, etc., but at least in my experience, like, he's literally like, dekhen jo khuda chahta hai, dekhen jo achhi team hoti hai wo kabhi bhi jeet sakti hai, cricket game chance ka game hai, kisi ka bhi chance hai. And iski sabse achhi misal ye thi ke, and I've told this story before, maybe the last time you were on air as well, ke main aur Cheema aur Rehan subah ke 6 baje Sri Lanka versus South Africa 2015 quarter final preview show gaye the Saklan ke saath, and the three of us were like, South Africa has never won any knockout match in any freaking situation, so they're going to lose, ha 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 lol. And Saklan got really mad and he was just like, ye nahi keh sakte, any day kisi team ka bhi chance hota hai, cricket ka game hi chance ka hai ye wo. Rehan and Cheema didn't give a shit, and like I was really upset. I was like, "Did he take his clan back? Did he take my baat?" And he was just like, he got really mad. And Rehan was kind of like, "Bhai, Ahmed, just let it go. Like, we're not gonna win him over with this." And then freaking South Africa won that.
Yeah, this is a beautiful thing about the clan. वो किसने क्रिकेट काउच ने सुभाष डिड एन इंटरव्यू विद विद सकलैन लाइक मे बी ऑलमोस्ट 9 years ago नाउ, एंड ही
he did it for the Cricket Monthly, and he set out to talk to him about, like, you know, coaching and cricket and dusra and stuff. And basically, he turned in like 3,500, 4,000 words of pure, like, Sakhlain, just the first iteration of Kudrat Ka Nizam, you know, philosophy,
yeah,
life, the great mysteries of life. It's a very, 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 as Imam ul Haq might have said 4 years ago, hella entertaining chat. But my God,
yeah,
like, it really was like a really seriously entertaining chat. And, you know, maybe that's just him, yaar. Woh aaya, usne ki ye bahut badi innovation zindagi mein kari, aur phir chala gaya. Bas, theek hai, yaar. Kuch log hote hain aise malang kisam ke insaan.
Can I just also throw in ki he's...
Maradona, like, for me, like, in terms of just the genius of a player, in terms of bringing new things to a sport, Maradona is, like, the best of all time. So, Maradona, ke as a coach, aap kabhi interview sune, yeah, Maradona trying to explain what he did on a football field. Like, all he talks about is passion. All he talks about is, kisko maar do, iski taang tod do, aur iski taang ke andar se gend nikal do. Kaise karna hai? It doesn't exist. Right?
And that's
a problem. Like,
Maradona is not just case toro, uski pehli hote hai ki ye sab mujhe maarne aa rahe aur mera akela bachne ka tarika ye ki maine pehle maar do. And it's just like, dude,
yes,
you're describing a football game. Like, why are you talking like this? He's just like, they all wanted to kill me and I had to kill them first. Like, okay, Mara, Diego, relax. But I also wanted to throw in, because we're talking about crazy men, ke Sakhlain, you know, is a, like, cricketer of the 90s, so, like, rock star, who then also goes the, you know, the Maulvi way and everything. And I remember that he would be on Twitter posting these pictures of, like, his face made up with, like, all this makeup done by his daughters, and he would keep posting those online, and, like, these super cute and super, like, comfortable with his masculinity content.
Yeah.
And I don't know which one of those daughters married Shadab, but, like, we saw that whole chapter grow up, and you could see that Sakhlain was a great girl dad. Like, that was really, really beautiful to see that, like, he, you know, I think he really kind of was so comfortable with it, because wohi ke ek tarike se ke halal haram wale bhi us pe ilzamat lagte hai, ya just simply ye kis kisam ki mardanagi hai. And, you know, I think what we've all been talking about, like, uska jo kya main kahunga, malangpan hai, is visible through these kinds of things.
I think without that malangpan, you don't invent a dusra. Without the person, without how the person is, I feel it just translates onto any sport that you play. So, like, if Asif was any different to what we know Asif as off the field and jo bhi uski stories aati hain, to I don't think Asif ki ball usna jhoomti agar, you know, that saying ke wo khud itna na jhoomte. So, you know, there have been a lot of examples of this. Like, the other day you were talking about another crazy, like, talented cricketer. Which said, like, Sakhlain was never east level ka crazy. It was Raza Hassan, the left arm spinner who came in. Like, you meet the guy and you talk to him about cricket, he will all day long will have a ball in his hand. He's doing something new. Ke main aaj ball jo hai wo aaj meri itni spin hogi, aaj itni spin hogi. Or he can't explain what he's doing, but when he throws the ball like that, to uski ball utni spin ho rahi jitni wo bata raha hai. एंड उसके बाद आप उससे मिलोगे तो वो लेट है प्रैक्टिस पे, वो कभी टाइम पे पहुंच रहा है, कभी नहीं पहुंच रहा, कभी वो गाड़ी पुल से नीचे उतार रहा है, कभी वो पता नहीं क्या कर रहा है, बट दैट ऑल ऑफ दैट इज बिकॉज उसका दिमाग इज ओवर वर्किंग एंड ही इज अ मलंग इन हिज ओन वर्ल्ड. दैट्स व्हाई ही कैन कम अप विद दीस थिंग्स. अगर वो ना होता तो ये भी ना होता. दैट्स हाउ आई फील अबाउट. या
काफी एक ट्रेडिशन है पाकिस्तान में. आई वाज जस्ट यू गाइस वर टॉकिंग राइट नाउ अबाउट द काइंड ऑफ पर्सनालिटी. You know, I'm being an old man here again, but Sarfaraz Nawaz, you know, people say obviously ke reverse swing Sarfaraz Nawaz ne invent kari thi or whatever, but I when I spoke to him once about it, you know, the way he explained himself was exactly this, ke haath pe jab ball thi na, to he would play on all kinds of different pitches. Wo Lahore Jimkhana ki turf pitch hoti thi, but most of the places he played at, wahan pe batting wicket hoti thi. तो ही यूज टू बी, वो कहता था कि यार एक बार मुझे किसी ने दिखाया था कि अगर बॉल ऐसी हो ना तो शायद इस तरह से कभी कभी स्विंग होती है. बस उसने मुझे ये नहीं बोला कि ये पुरानी बॉल ऐसे होगी या ये होगी, उसने बस मुझे एक बार ये दिखा दिया. उसके बाद से मेरे दिमाग में खुजली होती थी कि यार ऐसी पिच पे अगर मैं ये कराऊं और इस बॉल को ऐसे करके वो कराऊं, यू नो दैट काइंड ऑफ, इट साउंड्स टेक्निकल बट इट्स एक्चुअली जस्ट मलंग के यार आई वांट टू डू समथिंग दैट इज something that other people have not done, or going against the grain. You know, that contrarianism, it's the mother of invention, actually. Yeah. And Satyanki's story, I forget the exact details now, but he also kind of invented the dusra, I think, sitting on his rooftop, a flat, kuch ping pong balls hai, kuch wo karta tha. He used to play around and stuff because I think he was, you know, constrained for space or something, and then used to play around, and that's how he kind of started bowling the dusra, which is where all great kind of innovation, you know, I think comes from.
I think yahi main chah raha tha ki, in fact, iski agar history ko contextualize kiya jaye, kyunki yes, individual personalities matter, but also ke aapke jo social kind of wo bhi hai ki Pakistan mein khas karke bowling has always been something that people are into, right? Like, when you look at, like, for example, football, mein Italy loves its defenders. I think Pakistan cricket ki defending is bowling. Pakistan's always loved that. And isiliye matlab aap wo dekho ke jo tape ball cricket hai, which in itself is a Pakistani indigenous invention, magar uske andar bhi ek to hai ki ek side se aap phaad do to you're replicating reverse, which before I knew what reverse swing was, I knew this because gali mohalle mein sab log agar depending on the rules, agar koi kar raha hai to outrage ho rahi hai ya allow hai ya nahi hai, whatever the hell. Usi ke saath saath jo Nadeem Finger jis wajah se mashhoor the ke, you know, like using that ball, compressing it, and which is now, what is it called? Carambol, jo hai wo karana, you know, that, like, whether it's Sarfaraz Nawaz or whether it's Saqlain or whatever, like, they're also growing up in a cricket culture jahan pe ek kind of curiosity and celebration hai of doing stuff with the ball, right? Like, I think, for example, in India, you see, like, a lot of great batters come out because there's a, and in fact, that was one of the explanations for why India doesn't have good pacers for a long time. Ki ji, koi wo, there's no heroes to look up to even, you know, and now maybe that's changing for them. With Pakistan, always, they, particularly up until, like, you know, this, the good old days, that there was a lot of kind of celebration also and precedence of people coming up with, like, innovative ways of just bowling the cricket ball.
Yeah, I wanted to ask a question to both of you on this as well. Is ke Pakistan ki cricket ki success has always been, like, for me, when I look back, and, you know, 92 ka World Cup, jitna marzi main claim kar lun ke mujhe yaad hai, main 4 saal ka tha, 4.5 years old at the time when Pakistan won the World Cup, toh उसकी सिर्फ ये मेमोरीज होती हैं कि जी, यू नो, अम्मी अबू खुश हैं घर में, यू नो, शोर भी है वो. उसके अलावा आई डोंट रिमेम्बर मच, राइट? सो आई लाइक देन आई लुक्ड अप स्कोर कार्ड्स, और मैंने स्कोर कार्ड्स देखे तो रैंडमली इमरान खान हैज प्रमोटेड हिमसेल्फ टू नंबर 3, ही इज रैंडमली गोइंग इन द सेमीफाइनल एट नंबर 3. देन यू लुक एट द 2009 T20 वर्ल्ड कप वेयर लाला स्टार्ट्स गोइंग एट नंबर 3, राइट? देन यू सी द 2017 चैंपियंस ट्रॉफी विच पाकिस्तान वन, where, like, every country is thinking about how to bowl the new ball kaise karwani hai aur aapne runs kaise rokne hai. Pakistan is bringing Junaid Khan back in the middle overs and exploiting reverse swing in those conditions, and England mein sari nayi ball ki baat kar rahe hain aur Pakistan reverse swing kar raha hai. So every time Pakistan has done well, you know, dusra, reverse swing, everything, it's innovation, koi jugaad nikalna, koi apna tarika nikalna, and yet our cricket discourse, like, from past cricketers as well, it's all about conventionalism. Ki technique nahi theek, sar nahi sahi aa raha, paon nahi sahi aa raha, iska action nahi theek, iski leg bend nahi honi chahiye. Leg bend na hone wali cheez pe to mujhe sabse zyada gussa chadta hai, because the greatest fast bowler of all time, his leg used to bend like no one else's, but yet he is the greatest fast bowler of all time. So I mean, ye cheeze, why does this happen in our discourse even now, despite I think
you know, it's the way those things get perceived and analyzed. Jaise ये जो तुमने तीनों एग्जांपल दिए थे ना, इमरान खान के प्रमोटिंग हिमसेल्फ टू नंबर 3 इन द वर्ल्ड कप, 2009 में लाला गोइंग अप टू नंबर 3 इन द T20 वर्ल्ड कप, एंड जुनैद खान बोलिंग इन द मिडिल ओवर्स इन 2017. ऑल दीज एग्जांपल्स, दिस इज लाइक, इन हर में रैंडमनेस नहीं, लॉजिक थी पाकिस्तान की, राइट? सो इमरान की लॉजिक ये थी कि हिज बैटिंग ऑर्डर वाज स्ट्रगलिंग, सलीम मलिक हैड कंप्लीटली डिसअपीयर्ड इन दैट टूर्नामेंट, जावेद की बैक की इंजरी थी. And Inzi, he didn't want to push up to number 3 because young tha, naya tournament tha. And Imran us waqt tak, you know, ek accomplished batter ho gaya tha. So he thought, okay, I will take that role on because I can bat. Not that gets seen as, yaar, dileri thi, ye hoti hai bravery kaptan ki. Yeah, bravery or what, that, you know, that's a secondary thing. The primary reason for it was the logic that I am the best batter for that position, right? I move myself up. Afridi ka, Yunus Khan se meri baat hoi hai. Yunus Khan इसके बारे में उसने कई बार बोला है कि यार हमारी लॉजिक ये थी कि वी नीडेड सम इम्पेटस दैट वी कुड डू विदाउट रिस्क. आजकल उसे कहेंगे लो वैल्यू विकेट, राइट. वो कहता था कि यार हमें थोड़ी सी पुश चाहिए थी, सिर्फ मेरी जो बैटिंग थी वो वैसी नहीं थी, हमें थोड़ी सी पुश चाहिए थी कि अगर शाहजेब नहीं चलता है तो उसके बाद यार कोई आए जो रन बना सकता है उधर और तेजी से बना सकता है, लेकिन अगर वो आउट हो जाए तो इतना भी हमें नुकसान ना हो. वो उस जमाने में यूनुस खान बात कर रहा है, आजकल हम लोग कहते हैं लो वैल्यू विकेट, यू नो. सो देयर वाज दैट लॉजिक. 2017 में जुनैद की आई एम नॉट श्योर व्हाट द लॉजिक वाज अदर देन द फैक्ट दैट यू नो दे वर फाइंडिंग रिवर्स एट द टाइम. दिस इज लॉजिक अगेंस्ट द लॉजिक ऑफ अदर लॉजिक्स एट दैट टाइम और अहेड ऑफ इट्स टाइम. इट्स बेसिकली इनोवेशन, राइट, दैट्स व्हाट इट इज. लेकिन हर इंस्टेंस में इट्स एनालाइज्ड इन द वर्स्ट वे पॉसिबल, यूजुअली इन पाकिस्तान. यार ये दिलेरी थी इमरान खान की, वो लाला बड़ा बिग गेम प्लेयर है, ये इसीलिए वो आगे गया, ये गया. यार ओके, देयर इज दैट, बट लुक एट द अंडरलाइंग लॉजिक अबाउट व्हाई दे मेड दैट डिसीजन, यू नो, व्हाई दे मेड दैट डिसीजन टू सेंड हिम.
आई मीन आई थिंक के पाकिस्तान में इनोवेशन क्रिकेट पे भी अब एक 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 चीज साइकिल्स के भी तौर से है, राइट. लाइक के यू डू सी एटलीस्ट के वेदर इट्स सकलैन और वकार, वसीम हैजंट कोच, बट लाइक अ लॉट ऑफ द 90s गाइज हु इनजी, all these guys who themselves and one way or another brought new things to the game as Basim coaches
has captain, by the way.
But Basim bhai ka ne Basim bhai ne kahan coach kiya hai, wo jo IPL mein
Kolkata
theek hai but like I think he was never the head coach there, right, he was the bowling coach. So, like I think if Wasim, we don't have enough of sample sizes to see like what his teams would play like, but you can see that with Wakar, with the Inzi in particular, and then to a lesser extent Saklan and Mushik, they're not bringing the kind of new age thinking and boldness and whatever. Like the Wakar to very openly talks about this, and you can see it that he's rebelling, like, or he's kind of disciplining his younger self as his older self, right? Like he hates who he was as a young person or whatever. That's mean, but you know, he's kind of reacting to that. But you see that with a lot of them. And I feel ke Pakistan mein kabhi wo nurture to nahi hogi innovation. To wohi hota hai ke jab koi ek generation aati hai that doesn't care so much or that isn't so, you know, intransigent. Because like with the 90s guys also, they had so much success ke abhi bhi unka, ke aapko, matlab, you know, there's still that expectation ke main daddy. Matlab, you talk to most of them and they're just like, ke, I'm willing to listen to other opinions, but ultimately, like, I'm the GOAT or one of, you know, or wo us sense mein it's, I think it translates into inflexibility, because at least in terms of the kind of coaches or teachers they've become, they have not used that kind of quick thinking that defined their careers.
I think the best example, by the way, and we're over an hour now, so we should kind of wrap up. I want to wrap up with some Saklan wickets. But the best example of this innovation argument is another one of Rehan's favorites, Saeed Anwar, who was actually, you know, we talk about 90s, we remember that Jayasurya, Great Batch, all these guys were like innovative pinch hitters. Actually, no, it was Saeed Anwar who was doing that pinch hitting a good 2 years before Jayasurya and Tendulkar started making that role their own. You know, he was striking at a strike rate that had not been seen for anyone who had scored over 1,000 runs as an ODI opener for a while. But, you know, I still feel like it took the success of Jayasurya and Tendulkar to then validate that, okay, yes, Saeed bhi kar leta hai, toh theek hai. Varna, shuru mein jab wo kar raha tha, people were like, yaar, ye toh Lapetu type player hai, ye kya karega, Tapia hai, Lapetu hai, nahi kya. So, it's a weird relationship that Pakistan has had with innovation, even though it's shown that it is capable of producing it. Not quite sure how to handle it, and like you were saying just now, Ahmed, how to then pass it on, how to pass on that kind of thinking to a younger generation, because you yourself are never like fully comfortable with ki maine acha ye kara tha, you know. But I wanted to pick some of your favorite Saklan wickets, man, because I was, you know, for that article I was going through like a lot of his wickets. Damien Martin, let's take that one out because that's everyone's favorite, I think. I saw one wicket which I'd forgotten about, which was late era Saklan. This was in a really bad series in which usne 18 wicket li thi magar bahut hi bad strike rate pe, which was the 1-0 loss to England in 2000 jo ghar pe hara tha Pakistan pehli baar Karachi mein jo jeete, bahut hi gandi series, exactly, bahut hi gandi series, lekin usme Saklan ne jo wicket li thi Marcus Trescothick ki, I think England were like 84-0 or something, and obviously Pakistan weren't bowling so well, and Saklan comes from round the wicket. सो एंगल वो क्रिएट करता है एंड ही पिचेस इट लाइक मैन इन माय माइंड इट्स लाइक 3 feet, 4 feet आउटसाइड ऑफ स्टंप एंड डेस्कोटिक ब्यूटीफुल सीज अ ड्राइव एंड इवन नॉट अ ग्रेट फीट मूवर बट ही गोज टू ड्राइव और वो जितनी स्पिन हुई है इन टू हिम सो द दूसरा बेसिकली एंड अवे राइट इन टू मिडल टू लेग स्टंप बोल्ड हिम. It was actually the first time that I remember seeing that delivery. I thought, actually, he can turn it like Murli when sometimes. Because Murli used to get that big turn off the dusra. And I was like, damn, man, it's a kafi turn hoti hai sa clan ki. It was a bit of the angle as well. But it was just like one of those, wow, where did that come from? Crappy series for Pakistan. Not a great series for sa clan, even though he ended up with 18 wickets. And by that time, he was bowling the dusra so much ki uski thodi si mystery utar gayi thi. But like, that was just a reminder ki, yaar, phir bhi, like, the guy is the daddy.
वो 12:30 बजे टेस्ट मैच खत्म हुआ था रात के कराची वाला ओह गॉड टेरिबल.
I remember the match and I had to look up the wickets and they're not classic wickets but it speaks to what a crazy captain Wasim Akram was. In fact, he highlights this series as like the peak of his craziness. 96 Carlton United board series in Australia. We playing in Adelaide defending 220 something. Saqlain is bowling at the death. He's bowling like the 48th over and he picks up the wickets. He takes a 5-4, he wraps up the match. But like, I think if the reason I wanted, I mean, mujhe match hi isliye yaad tha ki yaar, it was crazy that Saqlain essentially was, you know, like a Wasim Waqar level kind of bowler, just bowling at a slower pace. But like, he's got like, five different, like he had a lot more variety than anyone except Wasim. And he was, you could bowl him at any phase of the game, particularly wide ball. Mein, he was devastatingly good. I think his wide ball peak to me lasts even longer because he was amazing. You could put him in any kind of situation. And to think about, like, yes, obviously batting us waqt is tarike ki nahi thi jaise ab hai, but tab bhi ek wide ball mein off spinner death pe karana is crazy. And he was. Excellent at it.
I think my favorite one is from the same series, wo jo Chennai wala test match sabko yaad hai jisme Tendulkar ne nikal ke mara tha and he got caught by Wasim bhai at mid off or cover. I don't exactly remember, lekin usi series mein I think is he gets Tendulkar out. I also put, that's the last video on my video as well, the last clip jisme Tendulkar basically usme aise laga when he plays that shot, he's like, how dare an off spinner bowl to me? Like, peak Tendulkar at the time was something else, like wo Desert Storm and, you know, Australia ko usse pichle saal wo Sharjah mein udana, uske baad India mein Shane Warne ko completely destroy karna. I remember Shane Warne ne usko bouncer karwa diya tha ek match mein because he was so tired of bowling leg spin ki usne bouncer karwa diya tha. And that's how good Sachin was off spin. And Sachin just advances down the track and he's like, ke ye to, how dare this happen to, you know, Sachin Tendulkar? And he goes towards mid-wicket, I think, and uski dusra hota hai, gets caught at point. And I remember the commentary on it. The commentary on it exactly was, that is a terrible, terrible shot. I don't remember exactly who said that. But for anyone to say that about Sachin Tendulkar playing against a spinner, I don't think I've ever heard anyone ever say about Tendulkar playing a spinner, ke that's a terrible shot. That's not a terrible shot. Saqlain makes it look that terrible. Because he's completely out of shape. Uska bat idhar ja raha hai. Or everything, like you talk about Tendulkar ke, टेक्निकली करेक्ट, उसकी बॉडी शेप कभी खराब नहीं होती, वो मगरा को निकल के छक्के मारता है, स्पिनर क्या चीज है, हिज एंटायर बॉडी शेप गोज अवे एंड ही गेट्स अ कॉट एट पॉइंट एंड आई थिंक दैट्स फॉर मी दैट्स वन ऑफ माय फेवरेट Saqlain विकेट्स.
या ऑल इन फैक्ट आई फील इट्स इज सो बिजार फॉर मी व्हेन आई वाज थिंकिंग अबाउट दिस बिकॉज यू नो माय क्रिकेट फैंडम बिगिंस इन द 90s के I was so spoiled that I just believed like a bowler like Wasim or an offie like Saqlain, like that's all I knew, right? So, matlab, I didn't really think it was crazy things, right? Like, because I remember, like, I think about this, that when I'm sleeping at night and Amar, you know, the cricketer is playing in my head and I try to put myself to sleep. Since I was a kid, he, like, that, the imaginary Amar can always move it both ways. And there's just this assumption that every bowler can do it inside and out. Because in the 90s, like maybe other than like Waqar with the in-swing, itni koi wo nahi thi. But other than that, like all of them, like, even Akib and stuff, you know, they were bowling at a level that was frankly like ridiculous, you know. And I think like that's one of those things with Saclan, okay, now like I'm looking at this match or I'm looking at these clips and some of these things what Rehan is saying, okay, yeah, in 99 it didn't hit me so much, but now thinking about Tendulkar losing his body shape trying to hit a spinner is actually wild, because I have so much data that shows that almost never happened. Us waqt ye tha ke this is what Pakistani bowlers do. So,
yeah, wo Shoaib Akhtar aake do yorker maar dega, stumps ud rahi hain, usko pata
nahi game play. Yeah,
ye kaun batting kar raha hai mujhe kya pata kaun hai. So yeah,
but anyways, but on that,
I just, before you wrap this up, I'd recommend everyone ki aap kabhi Butterfast koi episode ho, वैसे तो show ka naam Butterfast hona chahiye, but Ahmer se please kahein ki wo imaginary Ahmer ke career ke bare mein aapko bataye, jis pe Ahmer by the way ek promo पाकिस्तान नेशनल टेलीविजन पे शूट कर चुके हुए हैं, जिस पर अपना बॉलिंग एक्शन करवा के बोला था एमर नकवी द ग्रेटेस्ट फास्ट बॉलर ऑफ ऑल टाइम.
We have to shoot promos for a show. And they're like, I'm gonna be like, hey, hi, I'm Rehan, watch me on whatever. And I was like, hi, I'm Pakistan's greatest ever fast bowler, Ahmer Naqvi. Watch me on this. And like, PTV guys are just like, do we shoot this again? Like, and I was like, hey, take it, bro.
Ahmer Naqvi is the least fast bowling name ever, by the way.
It is. I was like, if I am a cricket thing, you know, whenever I make it to international cricket, so I'll ask the commentators ki mera surname na le. So you Brazilian style mein, so I'll get Ahmer on the name. Ahmer, I think, is a good fast bowler name, but is
Ahmer, are we allowed to say that name, which I think is the greatest insult anyone has ever done to you?
Yeah. I think it's the only good nickname I've ever been given.
So, Usman, we were doing the 2015 World Cup show. So, Ahmer ne koi, I think, comment ki. So, humne wo episode chada, obviously, Twitter pe clips jaate hai. So, ek bande niche ne kaha ki, ye kaisi baate kar raha hai, Ahmak Nakli. So, that's stuck.
That's really good. That's
I'm calling up the Pakistan passport office right now and telling them that this is not his name. His name is Ahmer Naqvi. That is the greatest. I don't think I'm ever going to call you anything else ever again in my life.
I did this for 2 years. Kept calling him Ahmer Naqvi. So yeah.
There's only Asli, guys. But anyways, on that note, Rehan, thank you so much for being part of the show. We're going to be posting Rehan's video that he was talking about, as well as Usman's article, in the links below, as well as whatever else we decide you need to read up to really understand how.
Ask the readers to send in their best Saclan wickets also.
Oh yeah, why don't you do that? Link to that in the comments below with your favorite Saclan videos, favorite Dusra videos, and we'll catch you again next time. Till then, take care. Bye bye.